Okay, in today's session, I explain about operating system services. Operating system is a software program which provides an user interface between user and your computer hardware. With the help of your operating system, you have to execute user programs. It provides services to the both users and the programs. It provides an environment to execute all the programs in a convenient manner. Various operating system services are, first of all, follow this diagram. A view of operating system services, user and other system programs. GUI indicates graphical user interface or batch interface or command line interface. Command line interface means your character user interface. These three interfaces are provided to the user. Based upon the user's requirements, the user may choose either GUI or batch or command line interface. In between, it has an interface as system calls. These are the system generated interrupts, which will act as the interface between user and your system. Those calls are called as the system calls. These are the various services provided to the user and the program. First one has here program execution, IO operations, file systems, communication, resource allocation, accounting, error detection, protection and security. Then next level has your operating system. And least level or bottom level, you are called as a hardware. This hardware, all the physical devices which can be connected to the system to execute a particular program. Hardware means like your CPU or memory or any resource or IO files or any keyboard or any devices required to execute a particular program. That is the hardware device. Now your OS will act as an interface between low level hardware to the highest level user and the system programs. In between, it provides various services. We have to discuss one by one. First one has user interface, second one program execution, third one IO operation, file systems, communication, resource allocation, accounting, error detection, protection and security. Just we'll explain one by one. First one has user interface. Almost every operating system, it provides a user interface. You have to consider, for example, DOS, Microsoft Disk Operating System. It will provide character user interface or command line interface, CLI, in capital letters displayed, command line interface. Means at the C prompt, the user must have to given the commands one by one, and those commands are to be executed. That is called as the command line interface. It displays all the character data only. There are no graphics, there are no images, there are no color screens. Only you have monochrome display adapters used. Only black and white monitors only available. That is called as the command line or character user interface. Best example for the command line interface as Microsoft Disk Operating System. Next, coming to the next category, batch operating system. Several jobs are connected to the similar applications connected to a batch. Those programs are executed. That is the batch operating system or batch interface. Third one has graphical user interface, GUI. GUI means it is a pointing devices are available, like your mouse, joysticks, all will be available in the graphical user interface. It gives the user very interactive interface to display the programs, to do the actions, or to develop any application. It uses all the audio video signals are available. In case of graphical user interface or graphics user interface, audio video signals, MP3 players like Paintbrush, MS Word, MS Excel, PowerPoint, all the Windows operating system will provide graphical user interface. Depending upon these three types of interface, the user requirements, based upon the user's requirements, the user may choose either command line interface or graphical user interface or batch interface. For example, they want to develop a payroll process. They have to use all pointing devices, then go for GUI. They want to use only black and white characters, then go for command line interface. Other than that, you have to same applications of entire payroll system of entire organization used, they may use batch interface also. Means with the help of user interface only, you have to create your program. Consider your Windows, for example, you have to click to start and open any notepad or wordpad. You have to type the program, save the file, and ready to execute. That is the next service provided by the operating system as program execution. The system must be able to load the program into memory and run the program and end the execution either normally or abnormally, indicating the errors. Means the OS will provide a loader program to load that object file or the exe file to the main memory and ready for execution. Entire program execution will be normally by exit a last end of the program, otherwise abnormally in between you have any exceptions or any some hardware failures or software failures are occurred, then there is an abnormal exit will be there. That is the way of program execution. The entire care will be given by the operating system. Coming to the third on IO operations. A running program may require IO, which may involve a file or an IO device. Means if you want to send any input data, you have to use IO device like keyboard. If you want to display the output to the screen, you may use printer or plotter or screen. Based upon the user requirements of the program, IO operations are to be taken place. Means input values are supplied to the program by using the keyboard. Output operations or output values will be displayed to the screen. Next one, file system manipulation. Programs need to write, read, and all the files and directories are created. Means once you have to choose one editor, you have to save in that file. Entire data can be placed in some secondary storage area. That area you are called as a file. Various file operations are provided by the OSR. If you have to create a file, write the contents to a file, read the contents from a file, delete the file, fetch the items in a file, list the file information, LS, or list of all the files in a directory, and permission management. Once you have to create a file, there are file permission management will be there. Means it provides three types of users. One as the owner, second one as the user, and last one as the X or others. Owner means who creates the file, that is the owner of a file. Who accesses the file continuously for read operations or scan operations, you are call it as user. Others, some unknown person, they have to execute the program only. That is called as the other. O-U-X means owner, user, and others. Those are the three permissions available for any file while creating a file. The OS will provide three permissions. One as write operations, read operations, and execute operations. Owner will have all the three operations are permitted. Means read, write, and execute. Some values are assigned for each RWX. For write operation, you have 4, read operation 2, execute operation value 1. Totally you have 7. 7 means the owner will have all the rights. He wants to write the data or modify the content, read the data from the file, and execute that file. That is the owner. User will have only read and execute permissions only. Read means to Execute means only one value. Total 2 plus 1, 3 value. 2 plus 1, 3. 3 is assigned to a user. And exit X. Others will have only execute operation. The value will be only 1. Execute means you have to execute the programs without modifying the content. Without modifying the content. Finally, regarding the file system manipulation, for each and every file we have either owner or a group or user or called as or others. Means owner will have the permission of read, write and execute. All operations are allowed to a owner. User will have only execute, read and execute operations. Others will have only execute operation. For example, if you want to develop any project, you have to create one project file. They have several files are included in the directory. The owner will have right to modify the contents of a project on any file. That is called as the owner. Some others will have no right to change the contents or modify the contents. Only they have to read the contents and execute that file. That's enough. For example, users are group, you are called as. Remaining people in the group will have read the contents and execute those contents. That is the group option or users option. Means if any changes modified done by the owner itself, these are called as the values are assigned to that particular operations are called as the carry beans. Carry beans means read, write, execute R, W, X. Read, write, execute operations. Read for value will be, carry bean will be 4. For write value will be 2. For execute value will be 1. For execute value will be 1. Total value is 7. Okay. Regarding the file manipulation, owner will have the highest values are assigned to handle those files without any unauthorized user access. Means security and protection also will be provided with the help of this owner group and others. Coming to the next function, communications. Processes may exchange information on the same computer or between the computer or over a network. For example, everybody know you have a communication channel like WhatsApp or Facebook. You have to exchange the information between the two processes or between the two computers over a network. That communication may be achieved through two ways. One as shared memory or message passing. Shared memory means both P1 and P2, both processes wants to share a same memory space. They can access the variables. They can access the program code. Everything will be sharing is possible. That is called as the shared memory. And next, coming to the message passing. Messages will be transferred from source process to the destination process. Source process to the destination process. After IO operations, you have the error detection. If you want to execute your programs, there may be errors like syntax errors or runtime errors. If any syntax errors may be occur, then debugging operation is taken place. You have to identify the errors and correcting the errors. If a syntax error called as a bug, an error in a program called as a bug, means debugging is a process of identifying various types of bugs or compile time errors. You have to correct those errors and it will generate a error free program that is handled by the operating system with the help of a debugger. with the help of a debugger. Debugger is a software program which will identify the errors and correcting the errors. The next operation is accounting. This service will keep track of which the users are using, how much amount of time the resources are used by the particular user. Means it maintains a log book, how many number of users are logged into the system, what type of resources are to be held with that particular user. That entire log table you are called as a accounting information. Next service as resource allocator. OS acts as a good resource allocator. It means OS assigns all the resources to all the users either by priority or first come first serve. Who will enter first to the main memory, that will be allocated first. That process will be allocated first. That means, for example, if process P1, P2, P3 are there, you want to execute all the resources. You have to, that user will send the request for the resource, like printer. It will assign that resource to that particular process. Second process also requests the same printer, but the resource will be held by the process P1. Entire execution is completed. The resource will be used by the P1 and it releases. Then that resource will be allocated to the P2. Until that completion of P1, P2 must be waiting for that resource. That is the good allocation. It allocates all the resources by means of some principle that is called as a applying scheduling principle. It will assign all the resources. Then OS, you are called it as a resource manager or resource allocator. For example, the resources may be either your CPU cycles or main memory or files or your shared memory or IO devices. All the type of hardware and software resources you are called as just resources. The next effective operating system service as protection and security. Protecting the entire data stored in the secondary storage without damage or without deleting the data, there is a protection mechanism will be there, and to provide security to that entire system without entering some unauthorized user, it will provide username and password mechanisms to access that particular computer. If you want to access that particular computer by means of user authentication will be provided. Now you have to use enter username and corresponding password. It is a valid username and password. Then only the user must enter into that system. It maintains all the users' IDs and passwords in a log table. You are called it as a log table. It will search with that log table. Both will be matched. Then only it will provide the privileges or access rights to that particular user. That is called as the protection and security mechanisms. Coming to the next one, as OS as a good scheduler. Scheduler means it will provide to execute multiple programs at the same time based upon the user requirement. One program will be executed one after other program based upon the scheduler. A scheduler is a software program which have to execute more than one program at a time by either time slice manner or first come first serve manner, or some basic scheduling policy will be there. Based upon that policy, you have to execute the programs one by one manner. That is called as a good scheduler. Now finally, I conclude the today's session as operating system services. It provides services in various ways. One as the user interface, second one as program execution, IO input output and file manipulation and error detection, accounting, protection and security, resource allocator, and then you have the good scheduling policies will be there. These are the various operating system services provided to the user along with the programs. What are the examples of CLI and GUI? And give examples.